Thank you. Falling on my head, take it falling. So I just judge didn't raise the talk into the cellar. I said I didn't like the way he got fucked up, sleeping on the job. Those raindrops are falling on my head, thick and falling. But there's one thing I know, the blues listen to weep me, won't defeat me. It won't be long till happiness steps up. Drops falling on my head. That doesn't mean my eyes will soon be turning red. Crying's not for me. I'm never gonna stop the rain by complaining, because I'm free.
Time is wasted. I got a lot of living to do.
go and people sing everything for you and me. Life's a bar, if only you know it, and it's all there waiting for you. You're alive, so come on and show me. I've got a lot of living, such a lot of living. Thank you.
Victim from the temperature change here, you know, it's heat wave until yesterday. So we had to throw out all the heat waves set, the entire Jimmy Buffett tribute and all that. That we're going to do.
What's next? Okay, we sort of had an order, but you know, I tend to go up and got a message for you to say. Okay, I think what we're going to do now is abandon this listening, go back in time. So this one became very popular just a few months ago. The last show I did here was the Las Vegas show. And it was a much more ambitious undertaking than I had imagined, because I'd been in Las Vegas. I really was very interested in the act of one particular performer who was a major influence on all of show business in the 70s. That's Wayne Newton, who I saw play two times in Vegas. And a lot of what these guys do, like I saw Brittany, she's now in her sort of late 30s, and you go back chronologically over your career, you know, and talk about the songs you did. So we start out with this song that I did way back in middle school. And then I decided, no, there's another song. This one became very popular. I'm going to loop it in with the second one, also from like that pre-pubescent, pubescent, because I was a late bloomer. So this is by a group called The Spiral Staircase. Remember what day it was. I didn't notice what time it was. All I know is that I fell in love with you. And if all my dreams come true, I'll be spending time with you. Oh, every day is a new day in love with you. A new way of loving you. Every time I kiss your lips, my mind starts to wander, and I always will be true. I know y'all feel the same way too.
Every day is a new day. Every
on my whole, you know, John Legend plagiarism band. Tonight I'm not feeling angry because it's my birthday.
Yay!
So, we have another 3 hours and 14 minutes. For those of you who think my birthday is July 9th, that is my Facebook birthday. That's because when I grew up, I watched all these cosmetic commercials with that same mouth open, like I described when I first saw Anna Margaret on the large screen. And they would always be lying about their age. There was these commercials to talk about that. So I thought, say, Dad, and he was, just stop and close your mouth, because I know flies will come in. I did have this, like, real. When I got to college and I met this gentleman, by the way, Tommy Mandel on the keyboard. I once ran from the age of 15, a daily user of marijuana. But, you know, I had this rep on the campus because, you know, I had really bad glasses. And I'd walk around like this, you know. And so even when I wasn't stoned, you know, so, you know, I became subsequently paranoid. One of those things that happens eventually. And I was just like, you know. But I heard Dusty Springfield do it, and I like that version even better, so I'm going to leave it the way she recorded. In the cool of the evening, when everything was getting kind of fair, I call you up and ask you if you'd like to go with me and see a movie. First you say no, you got some plans for the night, and then you stop and say, alright. Love is kind of crazy with a spooky little boy like you. You always keep me guessing, I never seem to know what you are thinking. And if a fella looks at you, well, it's for sure your little eyes gonna be blinking. I get confused, I don't know where I stand. And then you smile and hold my hair. Love is kind of crazy with a spooky little boy like you. Ah, spooky, yeah, 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 yeah. Tell you all of my heart has died to whisper. Just like a ghost, you've been a haunting my dreams. So I propose on Halloween. Love is kind of crazy with a spooky little boy like you. WMCA every week. It was on Fridays it came out. So we were all psyched, you know, we cut out of school a little early and go to Mel's, and he had those 45 cabinets, and he'd have the records in chronological, like the 10, and you just picked them out, and all 100. It was amazing. When a certain song started to dominate the charts, like the Archies was like number one for like a month. There was a lot of Motown. There was a period of time when the Beatles had five of the top 10, many of which were double-sided and all that. But there was a lot of one-name songs, you know, one-word names. Like we just did Spooky. And this next one was by a band from Holland. And maybe they were Flemish from Brussels, but I think they were Dutch. I saw them on Hullabaloo. The girl was like, what now in retrospect? Goth. Like she has black hair, tied up tight, and a lot of eye makeup. And she refused to make any eye contact with the camera, like the American singers, like Ann Parker. And she was just like, and you could tell that she really didn't get the lyrics. They were transliterated. And it was one of the first songs. I was in my first band when I was 11, and we got to play in the Andrews Huddy auditorium for a special assembly, and this was the song we did. It's called Venus. It's also been done by Bananarama later and used for a, still used for a Razor commercial that I believe is a Warner Lambert brand. So I'm going to give them permission now. Goddess on a mountain top, burning like a silver flame. Summit of beauty and love, and Venus was her name. She's got it, yeah, baby, but she's got it. Well, I'm your Venus, I'm your fire, your desire. Crystal eyes, making every man mad. Black as a dark night she was, got what no one else had.
Wow!
She's got it, yeah, baby, she's got it. fucking self account. And Barbara Streisand too is still alive. Thank you.
You are the one who can make us all laugh. and then you break out in chill. Please don't be sad if it wasn't them that you hurt.
you a beer. I'll buy you a beer anyway. I'm feeling exhilarated.
They were clouds.
sisters think the song is about you. Don't you, don't you? Well, I hear you went up to Saratoga, and your horse naturally won. Then you threw your wager down to Nova Scotia to see a total eclipse of the sun.
Official closure of the set, but there's one song that I always do. It's my big showstopper. I won't go to the whole spiel, but you know, I've been Tommy and I for years. Actually, no, there's one more before that. That's okay. But we've been searching. You know, by the way, yeah, this is what happens after 60 plus years of marijuana. So there was the year I stopped completely when I lived in Japan, where it's completely criminalized still. I was out in Colorado for the first time last month, and I just got one word to say, dude. and yeah, so we sometimes will do. I really look at like where, you know, there's a thin line between plagiarism and really good composition, just as there is between, you know, stupid and clever. That's from Spinal Tap. I've Brooklynized it to be genius and bullshit. But one of the songs that I do, I know where the influence comes from politically, but I actually figured it out finally one night while I was stone watching YouTube. But before we do that, we're going to do another one. One more that we, you know. Maybe we should just go with it. Yeah. So this one we've used to take a lot of songs from, and you know, there are a lot of songs it comes from. It's a song that I wouldn't characteristically do, but I sort of, like the other song, can't get through it without crying. I started a joke, which started the whole world crying. Started the whole world laughing. Oh, if I'd only seen that the joke was on me. I looked at the sky, running my started the whole world living. Oh, if I only see that the joke was on me. I looked at the sky, running by. Bye. place. Ooh, yeah, that the joke was on me. Thank you. Now here you go again. You say you want your freedom. Well, who am I to keep you down? Wish there was some words for you to explain the way that you're feeling. So listen carefully to the sound of loneliness when the heartbeat drives you mad. It's filled with remembering what you had, what you lost, what you had.
Changed keys a couple times. It forces me to get into my saliva gland character.
Let me use that as an excuse to polish off, by the way. Solo Foundation is a proud sponsoree of Lagunitas, which I understand is actually from Spain, where, like Colorado, marijuana is now legal. Hint, hint. So, we get this beer as a donation, and we hope you're enjoying it. It's actually a lot better than Bud Light, said. Okay, so this is one that was written by Chris Christopherson, who now lives in Nashville, Tennessee, a former member of the High Movement, and of course recorded by the late great age 27 Janis Joplin.
Well, busted flat in Baton Rouge, waiting for a train, feeling nearly faded as by jeans. Bobby dragged the diesel down just before the rain, rode us all the way to New Orleans. Well, I took my harpoon out of my dirty red bandana. I sang a song while Bobby played the blues. Well, when she all was slapping time, song that's driving new. Freedom's just another word for nothing left to lose. Nothing, and nothing, honey, if it ain't free. Wow, freedom, good wasn't good enough when Bobby sang blues.
Ismail.
Anyway, you want to hear one more?
More! Encore!
No.
You
get that, though, I know.
So, want to hear one again?
No.
Back in the beginning.
No.
Do we sweet jam yet?
Sweet jam?
Yeah, we can't do whipping post. It's like a one-year PM. So this one is, again, chronologically, this goes back to junior year, high school, falling in love with Beth Goldman and Betty Goldberg at the same time. Both had the same initials.
And they were in love with each other too, so it probably worked out.
Sort of. They did end up at the same college, but I got into a cult. A lot of things happened over the years. I look back, it was already a situation that I enabled where they just wanted to be friends. So I was a pretty lonely guy in junior year. Especially when my best friend, who's now the head of the journalism department at a Western University, stole Beth away. And the song kind of says it all, you know, it just captures that whole period of where it was more than just fucking Motown. So I'm going to start really slow. I usually do this routine where I'm at a bar at 3 a.m. with a drink and I'm on some clothes and I'm having another smoke. And,
except you and me.
The late Frank Sinatra, by the way, Barbara Sinatra, she's only 90 years old. Joined our necrophilia club. So if she had any material, there was a duet we did, Sandy. We could do that one again. Okay, so we're just gonna get on with the fucking encore already. And I'm proud I didn't use any Brooklynese until just then. This is my fork in the road. Love's last episode. There's nowhere to go. Oh no. Very similar to Dreams. You heard that melody there? Oh no. You made a choice. And now it's up to me to bow.
I'll be right back.
be there. So the sideline said, whenever you need me, I'll be there. Whenever you want me, I'll be there. When you call my name, girl, call me on the phone. I said, call me on the phone. Well, you want me, I'll be there. You need me, cause I'll be there. Want me, I'll be there. Yeah, that's it. Thank you.
Stick around, guys, but I'll put on some music. But
yeah, I'll
that is the show.